Oh yeah. Well, what's this? Evolution or gimmick? That is the tension whenever a new hobby product hits the market today. There are so many Kickstarters, there's a dizzying array of campaigns, and with an ever greater degree of sophistication behind the advertisement behind new hobby products, well, it's a little bit of a minefield out there. Products range from the sublime to the, well, frankly, underwhelming. Redgrass Games traditionally have a superb reputation. Their wet palette I'd consider to be the best on the market by some margin. So whenever you send these kind of promotional materials, it comes with a little leaflet telling you about the design, what they're heading towards, and more importantly, instructional use. So with this, this is where we come across our first fork in the road, our first evolution, our first change from the first membrane. There are two sides to the sheet. One side has more of a matte quality to it with Redgrass Games writing across it. The other side has a satin surface to it. The writing side must go face down on top a wet sponge. So that's the first point of divergence. There will be a new case coming up. Unfortunately, they're still so early in the design phase that they haven't been able to send them out to people to try out yet. So it's just the membrane. I don't know how it will affect the membrane going forward, but I'm hoping that it will avoid the major drawback of wet palettes, and that's paint blowout. Now, unfortunately, because you want to keep paint wetter for longer, the moisture from underneath the sponge works its way up through the paper, and it does have a tendency to oversaturate paint with water. It's one of the costs of doing business. So I'm hoping that this membrane will help mitigate it, if not outright get rid of that entirely. So we have Generation 2. What are the main differences between this paper and the old? Well, functionally, Redgrass Games advertises it in one of two ways. Firstly, you can use the paper three times. So you can reuse this. Once you're done with the painting session, you can go back, you can underneath a tap, get rid of excess paint, excess water, and just scrub it off. So it gives you more usability, and it promises no lack of performance. Secondly, there's a matte surface and a satin surface. So one sits on top of the other. The satin surface needs to be face up to put the paint on. The matte surface with the writing needs to be towards the or face down against the sponge. But you use the paper in exactly the same way. Add water to the sponge until there are no lighter spots, allowing for a small reservoir of water surrounding the lip. That way, when the sponge starts to dry out, it can soak up excess. The side with the writing is placed down onto the sponge, and the satin finish side up. So some staining may occur with the paper when heavy body pigment, such as Chimera paints, are used. The leaflet does say that there will be no lack in functionality, but it is a concern. It is something you need to keep an eye on. So I'll test the sheet using colours from Scale 75, Chimera, Vallejo, Formula P3 and Games Workshop, every popular paint brand I can imagine. Okay, first impressions. The paper feels different. It's thicker and has a shiny coat on one side. I didn't think this would have such a significance on my painting process. But the paint slides across the surface with a little bit of zip. It feels like using a tile. And this gliding sensation is missing from version 1. Thin paints, they feel a lot more responsive, and glazes hold their structure for much, much longer. One of the surprising things I found with this, after a prolonged session, when you start to create glazes on the surface, they do tend to dry out and you'll have to remix them. However, the glazes mixed on this surface, I was able to reactivate again, which was like a very nice, pleasant surprise. I think it's the satin finish. It helps reinvigorate the paint over longer sessions, and there's less absorption So the hydration goes one way, essentially. The paint isn't sinking or being drawn into that membrane. My trial miniature is this rather handsome Janus Drake from the Blackstone Fortress set. Just to put it through his paces for the first day. I'll cover it up and then see where we are the next day. So, day one experiment, favourable. It's looking good. The paint reacts well. There's an unusual glide across it. I'm more than happy with the performance so far. Let's see how it copes day two. Day two, there's a slight blowout of paint. Again, this could be due to the Generation 1 case. It could just be one of those things that you'll have to... It's just the price of doing business with using a wet palette. However, when paint blows out on the older membrane, I found it went quite gloopy and quite pasty. With this new generation, it kept its tension, so the paint kept its formation a lot more consistently. So when I remixed them, I felt like I was getting my paint back rather than I was fighting against like a completely blown out used paint. The paint was reactivated easily, actually, and the glazes were even reactivated with no loss of movement across the surface. The satin finish of the paper also meant that paint slipped off without issue when it came to cleaning it. And that brings me on to my next point, cleaning your new wet palette paper. So I ran it beneath a tap and gently rubbed it with a paintbrush. The paint, the membrane itself is robust enough. I didn't feel I was going to damage it. I didn't feel like it was going to break or tear in any places. And it was thoroughly all washed off. Even the heavy body Chimera paints that I used, there was ever so slight minimal staining to it. The leaflet does advise that you leave it overnight or leave it dry out. So let's allow it time to dry out and then reactivate it. And let's see what happens with this. Let's go into day, are we two, three? Yeah, let's go with day three. Day three. Pleasantly surprised. So when you get these kind of promotional materials, of course they're going to say it's the next best thing since sliced bread. Are you able to like reactivate this again and again and again and paint it again? My main concern was after washing the surface, that it would lose performance. It would lose some of that zip, that satin finish, and glazes wouldn't be able to be reactivated as easily as a fresh new sheet. I thought there'd be a slight amount of, absorption either way. But after the sheet had been cleaned and put onto the surface again, there was... If I was nitpicking, I'd say there's a slight loss in performance, but I'm not sure whether I'm trying to find a fault with this, because my feelings towards this new paper are so overwhelmingly positive. I feel like I have to be quite harsh and nitpicky in places. There was a minimal loss in performance, but very, very, very minimal. Paint still reacted in the same way as a new sheet. Glaze is still able to be created very easily, and they were able to be reactivated afterwards. Okay, the picture up on screen is a wet palette paper after it's been used four times. I did want to test this to destruction. I did want to see what its limitations were. After four washes, it's still going strong. There's still very minimal loss in performance. It reacts very similarly to, or it reacts in much the same manner as it did a fresh sheet. yeah, it's just a very, very nice feeling. Because with the wet pads we've been using so far, so, returning back to the question we posed ourselves at the beginning, gimmick or evolution? Is this product really so much better than the previous sheet? And is it better than homemade? Well, right off the bat, yes, it is a million times better than the homemade one. I've used homemade ones. Try this, you won't go back. The improvements to the sheet are substantive. They are substantive enough to warrant the upgrade. These are not minor changes, they aren't tweaks to a formula. This new sheet feels significantly different from the previous, and they offer more versatility to the working life of your paints. Not only will it keep your paints usable for longer, to a higher degree of performance, but it'll do so 3 times easily with proper care. So the verdict, it's good, it's really good. It's a meaningful change that tangibly improves the performance of the wet palette. The new case is intriguing, and if it's anything like a step up the paper is, it'll be an indispensable tool. I cannot wait to grab my hands on this. The new Kickstarter goes live the 20th of May, where you'll be able to pledge for the new improved version 2 of the wet palette case, as well as the additions on the side, including, oh God, I'm so happy they're bringing this in, a paint holder to stop you knocking over your null and oil, as well as new membrane paper. So 20th of May, you can sign up for advanced notification right now, and the link will be in the description below this video. Thank you once again for watching. And if you liked anything that you saw here, why not consider signing up for Little Legend Studio Patreon, where we have hundreds of video tutorials ranging from the great and the good to the small and the evil, where we cover leather, skin, textures, masterclasses. Indeed, everything that you've seen here will be produced into a video tutorial, and currently we are doing Magnus versus Rust, the entire scene with full color palettes, full splashes, full color keys. We're pushing out the red carpet on that one. Thank you very much. Catch you in the next vid.